So, your game managed to cross over from being a prototype and is now ready for polish and value tweaking? Hi, I'm Christina. I've always loved using the right tools and assets where they make sense, and I want to introduce you to some of my favorites for this stage of your project. This video is going to be divided up into three parts. 7 assets that bring some visual and audio oomph, 4 assets that help keep everything clean and organized in the editor, and lastly 1 asset that will help a lot in playtesting. Most of these I've been using for months or years by now. 4 are still rather new to me, but I enjoy working with all of them a whole lot, and I think you might see some you would enjoy as well. My criteria for tools are always that they need to be rather intuitive to set up and or have really solid documentation, fill in where my skills as a solo developer fall flat, and be actual time savers right from the first project. A big thank you to Unity, who sponsored this video. They asked me to showcase some of my favorite assets as part of their currently running Dev Days of Summer sale event and provided 4 more of my choosing I'd been eager to try. If you are on the fence about any asset, I highly recommend giving their demos and documentations a good look to get a feel for what might be in store for you. You'll find links to all the assets in the video's description. So this is my starting point. I have a medievalish castle hall. The king is greeting foreign diplomats, then a sudden magical forest appears, throwing everything into chaos, starting the main storyline of the game. The functionality is all there, but it still looks rather bare bones. Thus, the first step is fleshing out the world building with objects. We have a medievalish looking hall with ominous looking statues and thin windows. Guests enter at the far side across the hall and will have to step through the row of statues to reach the staircase where the monarch is going to appear, high above the floor of the hall, so the guests will have to look up and feel small. How can we make this hall give the impression of a powerful nation with a knowledgeable monarch? Foreign guests and diplomats, as well as the players themselves, should see this not as a nation to be trifled with. Decorating your game's world will make it feel a lot more lived in. Decorating with a purpose and goal will support the story you want to tell without having to resort to writing walls of expositional text. I'm using PolyPerfect's Low Poly Ultimate Pack as a basis for all of this because there are lots of asset packs that are super easy to combine it with. For example, I added elements from PolyPerfect's Poly Universal Pack, Synthi's Polygon Series, as well as KaiKit's Dungeon Pack to furnish the hall, and I'm sure there are even more artists out there who created packs fitting into this art style. During medieval times, books had been an immense luxury and treasure, so our monarch will showcase not just his wealth, but also his supposed knowledge by having a small library in a corner of the room. I added a huge ship as an art piece earlier, so I will showcase some things this nation's merchants found on their travels as well. But let's not spotlight them too much. Our visitors are supposed to think our monarch barely regards these treasures as anything special. Lastly, nothing boasts quite as much about power as weapons and symbols of clans and countries defeated. While having an audience with the monarch, he will stand in front of powerful weaponry. This is by all means not subtle in the least, but it is not intended to be in the first place. All of this informational overkill will give the impression of a mighty nation to guests, without having to write it out into lengthy text for the player to read. But all of this looks rather bland still. Let's implement fog and lightning by Chronect, and let's start with the lighting part. I have a couple stained glass windows, and I want the colors to influence the surrounding area, the light falling in, and the floor of the room. This will bring some much-needed colors in a sea of red, white, and grays. This was the first time I worked with this asset, but setup only took about half an hour and some cross-referencing with their demo scene. And I have to say, the result is absolutely looking gorgeous. After the attack is done, I want to fill the whole hall with dust and fog. It's really just a slightly tweaked preset it came with, but the result is exactly what I've been looking for. Gives it all a bit of an ominous feel. Okay, that being done and looking nice already, the lighting of the scene looks still a bit too bright and flat in general. The room is huge, the windows ridiculously tiny, there is no reason for all of this to be so bright. I go to the lighting settings of the scene and change the environmental lighting from skybox to color. And suddenly everything's dark. Bring in the candles! This might be a great moment to read up on optimization for lights, but that's a future headache. Still, everything looks a bit flat and harsh, so we will have a look at post-processing for the scene. Unity's build-in has been my go-to for a long while, but a few months ago I started using Beautify 3 and haven't looked back since. It's an amazingly powerful post-processing asset, which not only comes with a heap of cool extra effects, they also managed to structure everything in a way that makes it easy for me to pick and choose the effects I'm going for. The before and after really showcases the importance of post-processing, doesn't it? If there's one group of artists that are basically magicians, at least in my eyes, it's VFX artists. I enjoy playing around in VFX and Shadowgraph, but by all means, my skills impress nobody. That's why I'm super happy to be able to use great VFX assets like top-down effects by SineVFX. They are on a level of quality I don't think I'll be able to reach in years. Plus, there are amazing resources to learn from as well. If I ever take the time to learn, that is. Yeah, this looks awesome. More Mountain Stellar Feel Asset is a great tool to bring a static world to life. I'm using it to control the text box and slightly animate the people the player interacts with, but it can do so, so much more. And apropos text box, these are a bit bland, aren't they? I won't ever tire of recommending Text Animate by Fibucci to add emotions and effects to the written words of your game. This is an amazing asset I set up in every single one of my projects right from the start, and it comes with one of the best documentations I have ever come across. And lastly, we need some sounds. Infinisa's Universal Sound FX is a huge collection of very high quality sound effects that bring some much needed ambience to our whole scene. So let's have a bit of a before and after for the changes implemented. Yeah, I like where this is heading. So, with the art and sound parts handled, let's have a look at the mess we find in the hierarchy. I am terrible when it comes to working with big, cluttered scenes. And make no mistake, this only looks somewhat organized to be able to make this video in a reasonable amount of time. The first of four assets I recommend to tackle this is V-Hierarchy 2. I can have a zebra-striped hierarchy, for example, which makes reading it a whole lot easier already, or enable and disable elements right here and don't have to move to the inspector. Also, I can see which components are sitting on a game object at a glance. And through alt-clicking, I can set icons and color backgrounds. Additionally, the developer has a whole group of great editor-enhancing assets, all of which are used by now by default in every project. Especially VInspector 2 is ridiculously powerful when it comes to saving time. I can copy-paste multiple components at once, drag out components by alt-click dragging them out of the hierarchy, or have bookmarks at the top, for example. And if you are routinely working with big collections of assets, I also highly recommend you give Smart Library a try. You can sort assets however you like into collections you created on your own, without having to move them from their original place in your project, and you can have them show up in multiple collections at once as well. I also like to use it to create shortcuts to often used files in general. The fourth inspector-focused asset is, for once, not Odin Inspector, because we are at the polishing phase of our project, so I guess you already had that one set up earlier. No, this time I recommend Odin Validator instead. It took me a while to warm up to this one, and I'm sure I'm still barely scratching the surface of its abilities, but it brings a couple tools that I wouldn't want to miss anymore. Once installed, I get this icon in the viewport alerting me about things I told it to alert me about. In this case, missing scripts and empty objects in lists, for example. This might sound super minor, but I've been working on a long-term project for a couple of months by now, and the validator helps me keep my sanity and find things for me where I wouldn't think or remember looking. I really enjoy having it in my projects, but it does have a bit of an initial learning curve. The last entry in this list of assets is Quantum Console. Let's say you've built your project and want to test it. With it, you could change speed, reloading times, or health directly inside the built game. But here, for example, I want to test which lighting might look nice, so I set up lists with lighting objects, grab the lights, and have methods to toggle them on or off. By adding an attribute to the values of methods, I can now call these methods at any time. And this is not just for inside the inspector, but works and build projects as well. I've just begun using it a few weeks ago, and it is yet another asset I will be implementing by default into every project going forward. This console is a ready-made prefab, by the way. You don't need to create it by yourself. Well, these are my asset picks for projects that are past the prototyping stage. I had been using Feel, Odin Validator, Smart Library, vHierarchy 2, Text Animator and Universal Zones for many months, sometimes years by now. Low Poly Ultimate, Fog and Light, Quantum Console and Top Down Effects were new to me, but man do they bring a lot of value. Low Poly and Fog and Light are great assets I'm looking forward to finding more reasons to use going forward, and Top Down Effects are the reason I will be getting more effects by Sign VFX in the future. He's got some amazing gold VFX that caught my eye. I hope you enjoyed this. I always enjoyed seeing these kinds of asset compilation videos, and making my own was a lot of fun. For more recommendations, please have a watch of my video about great assets I created last year. It's still as relevant as it was then. Please give the video a like if you did, and I typically create tutorials on UI-focused topics, so if that catches your interest, please click subscribe. Do you have any assets you put into your projects and would recommend to others? Please leave them in the comments. I'm always looking for fun new tools.